At the end of this 1 year webinar, what we are planning. So I draw the attention of Dr. Shailendra. See here, every month, monthly webinar for 1 hour, we are covering two states, maybe few rural youth who are successfully introduced into agripreneurship. These things can be recorded. It can be placed in manage YouTube channel, so that only the success story part, not the other discussion, it has to be edited and put in the manage YouTube channel. So the webinar, series 1, 2, 3, 4, like that, people who are interested in skill training for rural youth, that will be also a study material. So any nodal training institution, from our YouTube channel, you can take those, this workshop deliberations, and you can use in your training programs as and when it is required. The second part, once you complete 1 year, so probably 25-30 success stories we will be discussing for next 1 year. And all the success stories you compile and publish a ebook, which we can circulate among all the nodal training institutions, and we can also put in our website, so that any rural youth want to start an enterprise, success stories are available at place. Any nodal training institution you want to teach in detail, more details and motivational success stories are available at one place. So that is the objective of this webinar. It has a good content and good intention also. I am sure that all the samitis and all the nodal training institutions will be greatly benefited out of that. And again, I am requesting all the samitis, still we have 1 month left in this financial year. And if you want to initiate more number of STRY programs, please write to us and initiate the programs instantly. So with this, I wish this webinar series a grand success. Our rural youth, our nodal training institutions, and our samitis, everyone will be benefited. And for us, manage, it is a great experience of learning and producing something which is useful for the society and to the nation. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir, for inaugurating this webinar series and also sharing your vision, the idea that you are having, the objective that we all are expected to achieve through this webinar series, and also emphasizing on the fact that STRY as a platform, in what big way it can be taken to bring those changes at the ground level, which we always speak about. Diversification in terms of new enterprises and also generate more income. So thank you very much, sir, for your time and for inaugurating this webinar series. Now I'll request Samiti Chhattisgarh to present the success stories. From Chhattisgarh, Dr. Deepthi Jha is there. Deepthi Jha will be presenting two success stories. One is on poultry rearing and other one is on mushroom production techniques. Now, the one thing I would also like to share with the participant that initially we were slightly apprehensive that we will just make it 1 hour arrangement. We will start with one success story only. But the kind of enthusiasm, kind of response we received, like I mentioned, Chhattisgarh was interested in presenting 3-4 success stories, but taking time into consideration, we asked them just to restrict themselves to 2 success stories only. So, Deepthi madam, you are now the presenter. You can just share your presentation and share the success stories. And if the farmer you are speaking about is also present, maybe at the last of your presentation, you can just introduce that person also.
Thank you very much, sir. DG Manage, senior officers from Ministry, Dr. Shailendra, officers of Manage, directors of heads of the KVKs, coordinators of NTIs, scientists and participants who have joined this webinar. A very good morning to all of you. Myself, Dr. Deepti Jha, I'm scientist and state coordinator, STRY, at Directorate of Extension Services, IGKV, Raipur. Today, I will present the success stories of two successful rural youth of Chhattisgarh who have taken their training under STRY. The presentation contains a brief introduction of IGKV, introduction of Directorate of Extension Services, success story of poultry farm woman, small video clipping, then success story of mushroom grower and a small video clipping. Let me start with the introduction of our university. Indira Gandhi Krishi Vishwavidyalaya is a non-profit research and educational organization that works for the betterment of the farmers. Education, research and extension are the major activities that has been coordinated by the university. There are 31 colleges including agriculture, horticulture, agriculture engineering and 27 Krishi Vigyan Kendras are working under IGKV. Now, Directorate of Extension Services. As we all know that extension is playing a major role in each and every field. So extension is one of the major mandate of the Vishwavidyalaya. Extension active, all the extension activities like melas, exhibitions, fairs, trainings, all has been coordinated by Directorate of Extension Services through KVKs. Again, this Directorate of Extension Services is a coordinating unit of STRY trainings that has been conducted by different Krishi Vigyan Kendras in Chhattisgarh. I will share the success story of Srimati Urmila Mandavi. She is a poultry farm woman and has taken the training under STRY. Srimati Urmila Mandavi is 26 years old and she has taken the education up to 8th standard and having a land of 2.5 acres. She has taken the training on poultry rearing and management in the year 2019, in the month of January. 24 sessions were planned during this training program and all the information related to poultry like housing management, biosecurity issues, vaccination schedules, feeding management, etc. All the information were provided to the trainees by the NTI. The master trainers of this training program are Dr. Prafu Chandra Rangari, Dr. Suryam Dora and Dr. Birbal Sahu. They are the masters behind this success story. Now this Urmila Mandavi has learned the backyard poultry rearing. She has converted the backyard poultry rearing to semi-intensive form of poultry, followed the proper vaccination schedules of the poultry birds, and also enhanced the feeding strategy of the poultry birds. She also learned the collective marketing strategies for selling the bird within the state as well as in the district. The impact of this training was that the farmers started scientific poultry rearing and they have adopted the artificial hatchery machine for the rearing. Also, mortality rate in the birds were reduced after taking the training. Proper marketing linkages were made and income were enhanced. Major learning from the skill-based training programs as expressed by Dr. Srimati Urmila Mandavi, the housing, she learned the housing management, feed management, day-to-day management of the poultry birds and identification of diseases and their treatments, vaccination of birds as well as the marketing linkages. This is a unit of Srimati Urmila Mandavi and birds are there in the unit. Next. Let's have a small video clipping. Let's have a look over the small video clipping.
से हूँ हम लोग मुर्गी पालन कर रहे हैं कड़कनाथ का कृषि विज्ञान केंद्र से हम लोग प्रशिक्षण लिए हैं कौशल विकास से और वहीं से प्रशिक्षण लेकर हम लोग अभी अच्छे से मुर्गी पालन कर रहे हैं और टीकाकरण भी कर रहे हैं
The impact of this training on other farmers was that the other farmers of that village, they also visited her farm and they learned various techniques related to poultry farming and they are also trying at their level to adopt this technology. The nodal officer of this training was Dr. S.C. Mukherjee, our director of extension. Myself was the state coordinator and the course coordinator of this training program is Dr. Birbal Sahu. Successful entrepreneur is Dr. Shri Ashwani Sahu. He is a mushroom grower and he has also taken the training under STRY. Ashwini Sahu is of 32 years age and he has taken the education up to BA Part 1. He took the training on mushroom production techniques in the year 2019 in the month of November. Again, 24 sessions were planned and all the information related to oyster mushroom cultivation, paddy straw mushroom cultivation, milky mushroom cultivation, button mushroom cultivation were provided to the trainees. Even marketing, how to save their mushroom and processing technology, it was also taught to the trainees. Master trainers of this training program are Dr. C.A. Shukla, Dr. N. Vagpale, Dr. H.K. Singh and myself. All of us are having expertise in mushroom. The major learning from this training was that hands-on training on mushroom cultivation, oyster mushroom cultivation, marketing channels for fresh and dry oyster mushroom, funding avenues for extension or expansion of the enterprise, and hands-off training on paddy straw mushroom and milky mushroom cultivation. Earlier, due to non-awareness of marketing channels of oyster mushroom, Ashwini Sahu was reluctant to take up mushroom cultivation. However, after taking the training, he was able to learn about the selling of the mushroom from the market, how to sell the mushroom from the market, and he learned so many other technologies of mushroom cultivations. In fact, he learned the proper drying of oyster mushroom that helped him to market the mushroom in a higher rate. From past 1 year, he is growing mushroom for at least 3 to 4 years. But from past 1 year, he is growing it on a commercial basis, and his production is 10 to 15 kg of oyster mushroom daily, and he is saving it at the price of rupees 200 per kg. The main thing is that he has further trained the 5 youths for mushroom production. After taking the training, this Ashwini Sahu has trained further 5 youths. For mushroom production, and they were also engaged in the mushroom production. His family members has also taken this business as an enterprise. This is the unit of Ashwini Sahu.
Namaskar dosto, mera naam Ashwini Kumar Sahu, Gram Govinda se, post Kesar Tashil Patan, Jila Dumri, Chhattisgarh se mushroom mushroom mein. Aur main agar 4 varshon se mushroom ki kheti kar raha hu.
Dosto main pichle 3 se 4 varshon ke beech mein is mushroom ki kheti kar raha hu. और इसके माध्यम से बहुत अच्छा इनकम अर्निंग कर रहा हूँ। ये मेरा पार्ट टाइम का बिजनेस है कि मेरा मुख्य जो बिजनेस होता है कृषि के अंदर का है, इसमें मैं फुल समय सबसे पहले आइडिया है यूट्यूब से, यूट्यूब के माध्यम से मैंने इसका शुरुआत किया और एक छोटे से कमरा में मैंने इसका 15 से 20 पैकेट डालकर मशरूम को देखा कि किस टाइप को ग्रो करता है। उसके बाद धीरे धीरे मुझे इसका अनुभव हुआ और मैंने 2019 में मशरूम की ट्रेनिंग, जिसमें मुझे अच्छा सा और जानकारी मिल जाए, इसके लिए मैंने IGKV इंदिरा गांधी कृषि विश्वविद्यालय रायपुर में ट्रेनिंग लिया 6-1 हफ्ते का। दोस्तों मैंने इसके बाद अब बहुत अच्छा मात्रा में इसका प्रोडक्शन लेना चालू कर दिया और मैं अभी लगभग इस सीजन में 800 पैकेट के आसपास इसका प्रोडक्शन ले चुका हूँ, जिसमें से मुझे लगभग 40 से 50 हज़ार की आमदनी हो चुका है। एक छोटा सा बिजनेस रूप में मैंने इसको देखा, क्योंकि मेरा जो अन्य बिजनेस है कृषि के अंदर का है। और अभी दोस्तों मेरा गर्मी का भी मार्च महीने का प्लानिंग है पैडी मशरूम लगाने का। पैडी मशरूम का भी मार्केट में लगभग 400 रुपये केजी है, तो उसका भी प्लानिंग अभी चल रहा है। और आमतौर पर हम लोग इस मशरूम को भी लगभग 160 रुपये केजी गांव के तरफ बेचते हैं, शहर में तो इसका रेट लगभग 200 रुपये है। तो अच्छे खासे इसके माध्यम से हमको मुनाफा प्राप्त हो रहा है। इसके अलावा मेरे साथ मेरे बच्चे, मेरे पत्नी और घर के लोग भी इसमें हाथ बटाते हैं, सहयोग करते हैं। वो लोग भी अच्छे से बनाने के लिए सीख चुके हैं, उत्पादन करने के लिए सीख चुके हैं। साथ में मेरे गांव से भी 3 से 4 व्यक्तियों को मैंने बताया और भी आज के डेट में अच्छा खासा इनकम इसके माध्यम से ले रहे हैं। बिहार योजना के तहत महिलाओं को भी हम लोग ट्रेनिंग देने जाते हैं, जिसमें आसपास के गांव से महिलाएं आती हैं या जब भी उन लोग बुलाते हैं तो हम लोग वहाँ पर ट्रेनिंग देने जाते हैं। दोस्तों तो आप सब जिसे मैं भी यही बोलना चाहूँगा कि मशरूम घर बैठे एक बहुत अच्छा व्यवसाय आपके लिए हो सकता है और इसके माध्यम से आप एक अच्छा बिजनेस पैसा आमदनी आप अर्जित कर सकते हैं। दोस्तों तो आप सब भी इसको लगाएं, यही आप सबसे मैं अपेक्षा चाहता हूँ। धन्यवाद।
आप सबको नमस्कार। मेरा नाम पिंकी साहू है, मैं ग्राम बुरंदा के रहने वाली।
मेरा पत्नी है श्रीमती पिंकी साहू, ये आंगनबाड़ी कार्यकर्ता भी है और साथ में मशरूम के व्यवसाय भी कर रहे हैं, मेरे साथ हाथ बटा रहे हैं, सहयोग कर रहे हैं। ये मेरे बेटी हैं कुमारी कामना साहू, जो हम लोग साथ इसका भी बहुत अच्छा ट्रेनिंग ले लिए हैं साथ में बोले जाए तो। इसके अलावा हम लोग जो है सूखा मशरूम का भी उत्पादन करते हैं। ये सूखा मशरूम है, इसको भी हम लोग सुखा कर बेचते हैं मार्केट में, लगभग 1,000 रुपये किलो में जाता है। इसके अलावा हम लोग इसका पाउडर भी बनाते हैं, पाउडर के अलावा अचार, बड़ी, ये ये सब चीज हम लोग बनाकर मार्केट में बेचते हैं।
मैं सबसे यही कहना चाहूंगी कि आप जो भी व्यवसाय कर रहे हैं, साथ ही इसको भी आप अपने व्यवसाय के रूप में जोड़ सकते हैं। लघु उद्योग के जरिए से ही मतलब कुछ आमदनी इससे भी मिल सकता है, इससे हम अच्छा आमदनी हमें मिलता है।
मेरा नाम साहू है, मैं ग्राम गोविंदा का रहने वाला। अभी फिर हाल बेरोजगार था तो मुझे मशरूम का ट्रेनिंग अश्विनी साहू द्वारा मिला, जो हमारे गांव का सहारा से मैं ये मशरूम का धंधा अपनाया हूँ। और यह विगत 1.5 साल से मैं करता आया हूँ। ये मशरूम का खेती हम सभी परिवार मिलकर कर रहे हैं, कम से कम 12 से 15 हजार मेहनत कमा लेते हैं।
उसके बाद जैसा मुझे ट्रेनिंग मिला यहाँ से, तो मेरा मेन व्यवसाय यही मशरूम का है और इससे मेरा परिवार।
तोड़ने के बाद हम लोग एक एक पाव का पैकिंग बनाते हैं और पैकिंग बनाकर दिल्ली में पैक करने के बाद सिटी एरिया रायपुर के नज़दीक जाते हैं और वहाँ पर हमारा मशरूम आसानी से बिक जाता है और इससे हमको पर डे आमदनी लगभग 700, 800, 1000 तक पहुंच जाता है हमारा आमदनी पर डे का, जो हमारे कार्य में टोटल सहयोग देते हैं।
नाम योगेश रेड्डी है, साहू है, हम लोग ग्राम गोरेंदा और तहसील पाटनगर छत्तीसगढ़। हमारे यहाँ मशरूम का काम करते हैं हम लोग। खास तौर पे अभी जो कोरोना का टाइम आया, उस टाइम लॉकडाउन हुआ था तो कुछ रोजगार ही नहीं मिला था, तो हम लोगों का आर्थिक स्थिति बहुत ही खराब हो गया, क्या करें कुछ समझ ही नहीं आ रहा था। तो उस टाइम हम लोग को कुछ सूझ ही नहीं रहा था, फिर हम लोग को बताया कि मशरूम काम कर सकते हैं, इससे मतलब घर का कुछ हेल्प हो जाएगा करके। तो हम लोग व्यवसाय को हमारे पापा के साथ हम लोग सभी लोग मिल के कर रहे हैं, इससे हम लोगों की आर्थिक स्थिति में बहुत ही सुधार आ गए पहले से, खास करके लॉकडाउन के टाइम। उस टाइम हम लोगों के पास कोई भी रोजगार नहीं था, तो मशरूम का जो व्यवसाय है उसे करके अपन कर रहे हैं। इस सीजन में हमारे यहाँ का 800 पैकेट उत्पादन हो चुका है और वर्तमान में 400 पैकेट और उत्पादन।
अभी हम लोग मार्च महीने के लिए गर्मी फसल के लिए पैडी मशरूम का तैयारी, और हम ये चाहते हैं कि ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा गर्मी सीजन में भी अपने पैडी मशरूम, जो इंसान बेरोजगार है उसके लिए यही संदेश देना चाहता हूँ कि वह कोई भी जगह ट्रेनिंग ले और इस व्यवसाय को अपने जीवन के हर मोड़ के तकलीफ को ख़त्म करने के लिए यह व्यवसाय करें। पहले छोटे रूप में करें, उसके बाद धीरे धीरे जैसा जैसा जानकारी होते जाते हैं उसके हिसाब से अपना व्यापार बढ़ाते जाएं, और यह फुल प्रॉफिट की व्यवसाय है, जितना करो उतना फायदा है।
जैसे मशरूम को हम लोग बेचने के लिए जाते हैं तो कुछ मशरूम बच जाता है, उसे सुखा भी देते हैं जिससे पाउडर बना सकते हैं, या तो सुखाएंगे नहीं तो उससे पापड़ या अचार बना सकते हैं। मतलब ऐसा है कि मशरूम वेस्ट अगर नहीं होता, उसमें कोई भी चीज मतलब हो सकता है, जैसे कि
और जो
सब चीज होने के बाद जो उसका कट्टी जो सूखा रहता है उसको खाद बनाकर हम लोग बेचते हैं।
You all have seen the success of rural youth as well as the impact of the training in the video, in the same video, sir. The impact of on other farmers is that the other rural youth from different villages, they are also contacting us to train them in the similar module, sir. One more information which I want to share with you all is that we got the information from our mushroom research laboratory that during pandemic COVID-19, they have saved the span of 2 tons. which clearly shows that this mushroom enterprise is highly encouraging the rural youth, sir. Again, nodal officer is the director of extension, myself is the state coordinator, and Dr. H.K. Singh is the course coordinator. Dr. H.K. Singh is present with us in this webinar. Next. I would like to acknowledge Manage Hyderabad for providing us financial assistance and for giving me opportunity to represent our state. Especially Dr. Shavendra, sir, he's always there to solve our queries. I would like to thank Samiti Chhattisgarh. I would like to thank Director of Extension Services, Special Dr. Mukherjee, sir, for his able guidance. In advance, I would like to thank all the coordinators of Krishi Vigyan Kendras and coordinators of Ethnic Mushroom IGKV Raipur. Without their support, we are not able to conduct this training program. Thank you and have a nice day. Stay safe and healthy by eating high protein mushrooms and Kadaknath chicken. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, ma'am, for sharing two important success stories. And these success stories also indicate that what kind of impact these short duration programs actually can create. And we also have to understand the impact created by these enterprises in the light of overall focus of the government that we are observing nowadays. Because government nowadays, whenever they are speaking about farmers, they are speaking about income realized by the farmer. For that, diversification is very important. And for diversification, if we are taking some activity like it may be poultry, it may be mushroom cultivation, 1 week is more than sufficient to orient farmer towards these enterprises. Some of the things that are also emerging from these success stories are that you have to integrate components like market, components like funding. You actually want farmers to successfully implement these activities, these enterprises, because as madam was mentioning about this mushroom cultivation, he mentioned about market, he also mentioned about processing. You are not only producing mushroom, but you are also coming up with different products of mushroom, value added product. Then you are speaking about linking the farmer or the rural youth with some source of funding. And as mentioned, madam mentioned, though it's not that detailed economics worked out, but still we can clearly see that one rural youth can generate something like 8 to 10 lakh rupees per annum from this single enterprise only. So this is the kind of scope these small duration programs are having. So thank you very much, ma'am, for sharing these two important success stories. Now I'll request Dr. Harmeet Kaur from Punjab. She will also be presenting two success stories. One is about organic production of medicinal and aromatic plants, and other one is about nursery management. Harmeet, madam.
I'll be highlighting the implementation of STR by Thrupameti. So as you are all aware that Pameti is a Samiti in Punjab. We have been operational in this very building since 2000. So I'll be highlighting the various infrastructures that we have. So in our house, we have three halls, one of 30 seating capacity, 60, and then 90. And each training hall has ADHs. We have one seminar hall, which has a video conferencing system with a full audio and visual aid facilities available there. And we also use video conferencing here. Then we have two IT labs for our IT trainings, and we try to use our IT labs in each and every training. We have a library where we have a collection of all the reading material that can be used by the trainees. And we also have a hostel which has around 24 rooms for the participants. So talking about the faculty in Pameti, we have director Dr. H.S. Dhaliwal, and we have 7 deputy directors. So now moving to two specific programs that I'll be talking is, one is organic farming, in which we talk about farming. School of Organic Farming in PAU is the coordinator for this program. So we have been organizing this program since we have been implementing STRYs. We have organized two programs like this. So discussing the schedule, we'll be having 24 sessions in a program, out of which we try to have 9 theory sessions and rest are the practical sessions. So you can see the schedule. All the faculty from the School of Organic Farming is involved in this, and they take the students in their labs, and we try to give a hands-on training. So this is the schedule with the breakup of theory and the practical sessions. Now coming to the success story. So we had one trainee, Mr. Akash Deep. For the mobilization of candidacy, since we are sitting in the university, we have majority of people are walk-in, people who come to university, people who wish to have some kind of a course, who are not in the formal education system and still want to learn. So these are the walk-ins we have. And we also associate with the ICICI Foundation, which is working in various districts, and they also bring their candidates. This is a paid training, so manager sponsoring this. So people are willing to enroll and get the hands-on training. So Mr. Akash Deep, he's 20 years of age, and he was only 10th pass. He was already having 2 acres of land, but on that he used to grow wheat and paddy cycle. So after he came in contact with ICICI Foundation, he came to us for the training of organic farming. So with the help of this training, he was able to diversify into vegetables. So the main the initiative that he took was he went to organic cultivation. That is, he did not increase his income by getting more output, but he was able to reduce his cost because of organic. He was reducing less consumption of fertilizers, less use of pesticides, and he was able to improve his income from 1 acre of land. So 1 acre he kept in his paddy and wheat, and 1 acre he converted into this. So the next, again from this training only, not the of the same days, but previous year, we have Mr. Sukhvir Singh. He belonged to Mansa, and same, he went for rotation and was able to earn a better income. So the main modification that has been introduced by the farmers is that they use now natural methods, they use less of chemicals, they use crop rotations, and that is how they are able to earn better. And the other thing is, because we are also teaching them marketing skills and taking sessions on marketing and roadside display models, they are able to connect with the consumer directly rather than going to mandis. They are able to connect with the customer directly, and these people are connected with these farmers, and they get a good price also. So his income improved, and he has become a model for other farmers. So the second training is nursery management, which was completed by Atma Faridkot, a training institute under PAMETI. And the schedule is here. Again, 4 sessions per day, 24 sessions are there. Now, Atma Faridkot normally brings candidates to PAU for a day or two, and these are the breakup of the schedule. So we have the farmer with us. He is Mr. Sandeep Singh. He is associated with Atma Faridkot. Sir, if I play the video, I think there will be a lag. Aap play kar sakte hain? With us, and Mr. Aman Keshav, who is also the coordinator for implementation of STRY at Faridkot.
Good morning, ma'am. Good morning, everyone. Good morning. मैं आपको शॉर्ट में एक छोटी सी स्टोरी फार्मर की बताऊंगा. ही केम टू अस फॉर अ ट्रेनिंग on nursery management because he wanted to shift from the rice and wheat rotation, paddy wheat rotation of the current scenario, and he wanted that he should be engaged in some other agriculture occupation. So what he did, we joined him for this nursery management course for 6 days, and we had 2 days of exposure visit to Department of Horticulture, Department of Floriculture, Department of Vegetable Science in Punjab Agricultural University through PAMETI. And we also had exposure visits and training programs on different nurseries which were located in the district only. So in this 6 days training program, we had arranged around 3 to 4 nurseries where we visited, and we had a hands-on session on each and every aspect of how to get involved in nursery management of all the crops. And by the end of the training program and by the end of the year, he has shifted his 2 acres of land from paddy wheat rotation to nursery management, And now he has been started this profitable venture, and he's doing this nursery, nurseries of vegetable crops, nurseries of agriculture crops in his area, in his village, and has been supplying this nursery of all these crops to the farmers. So it is a very good successful example of this. But I think Sandeep has lost the connection due to some internet problem. So ma'am, if you can play the video.
ਸਸਿਕਾ ਜੀ ਮੇਰਾ ਨਾਮ ਸੰਦੀਪ ਸਿੰਘ ਸਨ ਆਫ ਜਬਰਜੰਗ ਸਿੰਘ ਵਾਸੀ ਹਰੀਨੋ ਮੈਂ ਪਿਛਲੇ 10 ਸਾਲ ਤੋਂ ਜੀ ਰਵਾਇਤੀ ਖੇਤੀ ਕਰਦਾ ਸੀ ਕਣਕ ਝੋਨੇ ਦੀ ਪਰ ਉਹਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਬੜੀ ਸੰਤੁਸ਼ਟੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਸੀ ਉਸ ਤੋਂ ਬਾਅਦ ਮੈਂ ਆਪਦੇ ਰੁਝਾਨ ਨੂੰ ਸਬਜ਼ੀ ਵਾਲੇ ਲਾਈਨ 'ਤੇ ਲੈ ਕੇ ਆਉਂਦਾ ਸੀ ਪਰ ਲੈਣਾ ਚਾਹੁੰਦਾ ਸੀ ਪਰ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਪ੍ਰੋਪਰ ਨੌਲੇਜ ਨਹੀਂ ਸੀ ਇਸ ਚੀਜ਼ ਦੀ ਉਸ ਤੋਂ ਬਾਅਦ ਮੇਰਾ ਕੰਟੈਕਟ ਆਤਮਾ ਫਰੀਦਕੋਟ ਨਾਲ ਹੋਇਆ ਮੈਂ STRY ਦੇ ਅਧੀਨ ਉੱਥੋਂ 6 ਦਿਨ ਦੀ ਟ੍ਰੇਨਿੰਗ ਲਈ ਪ੍ਰੋਪਰ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਆਤਮਾ ਦੇ ਸੰਯੋਗ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਪ੍ਰੋਪਰ ਨੌਲੇਜ ਮਿਲੀ ਉਸ ਤੋਂ ਬਾਅਦ ਮੈਂ ਆਪਦੇ 1 ਕਿੱਲੇ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਨਰਸਰੀ ਦਾ ਸੈਟਅਪ ਤਿਆਰ ਕੀਤਾ ਜੋ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਨੌਲੇਜ ਮਿਲੀ ਸੀ ਜਿੰਨੀ ਜਾਣਕਾਰੀ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਉੱਥੋਂ ਮਿਲੀ ਸੀ ਮੈਂ ਉਹਦੇ ਅਧੀਨ ਇੱਥੇ ਆਪਦੀ ਗੋਭੀ ਦੀ ਪਨੀਰੀ ਆਪਦੇ ਲਈ ਤਿਆਰ ਕੀਤੀ ਅਤੇ ਪ੍ਰੋਵਾਈਡ ਵੀ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਵੀ ਦਿੱਤੀ ਉਸ ਤੋਂ ਬਾਅਦ ਹੁਣ ਮੇਰੇ ਕੋਲ ਫੁੱਲ ਗੋਭੀ ਬੰਦ ਗੋਭੀ ਟਮਾਟਰ ਸਮਝ ਲਓ ਵੀ ਆਲ ਪਨੀਰੀਆਂ ਮੇਰੇ ਕੋਲ ਇਸ ਟਾਈਮ ਤਿਆਰ ਨੇ ਇਸ ਕੰਮ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਮੇਰਾ ਆਤਮਾ ਫਰੀਦਕੋਟ ਨੇ ਬਹੁਤ ਸਹਿਯੋਗ ਦਿੱਤਾ ਜਿਹਦਾ ਮੈਂ ਦਿਲੋਂ ਧੰਨਵਾਦ ਦਿੱਤਾ ਸਤਿ ਸ਼੍ਰੀ ਅਕਾਲ
Ma'am, Harmeet, Dr. Harmeet Kaur, and thank you Dr. Aman for sharing these two success stories on organic production of medicinal and aromatic plant and nursery management. And means the basic idea, as I mentioned, was to share these success stories. And whenever you are going through any success stories, you will find that there are some learning points. As in case of Chhattisgarh presentation, I mentioned some keywords were integration with markets, funding, what kind of potential to generate income these enterprises are having. In this, you will observe that madam mentioned about the direct marketing, because government is having or has introduced recent past so many new policies, reforms. They are speaking about providing some alternatives to the farmer. One of the alternative is the ability or the freedom to market their produce directly in place of going to traditional market where generally price realization will not be that good. You can actually directly approach to your customer. It may be individual customer, it may be some direct retail market, or it may be some institutional buyer. So then modification of production practices also. He was already producing something, but after going undergoing this training, STRY training, he modified the way he actually was cultivating the medicinal grass. So these are some of the learnings, and that's what basically the idea of having this platform is. Because if you will go through the success stories, you will realize that every success story is having some keywords for you. If you are able to take those keywords and implement in your area, and more than that, generally we feel that the focus of STRY is on skill, and these are short duration, 6 days, 7 days, what we actually can do in terms of improving somebody's skill. But you can see that just in 6-7 days, so many things, so many new enterprises are possible. You can go for poultry, you can go for nursery, you can go for organic production of medicinal aromatic plants, mushroom production. And I'm quite sure next time, as we already have communicated, that next 16th March, we will again meet. And we have invited Tamil Nadu and Manipur to share their success stories. We will learn more about what these different states are doing as far as STRY is concerned. But one thing is very clear when you speak about these success stories, that these small short duration program can create so much of difference in the way you actually take up some new enterprise. So thank you, team Chhattisgarh. Thank you, team Punjab, for sharing the success stories. So this was, as I mentioned, that very briefly we will try to cover two states, that what we did. Now I'll request, before I request DG sir for concluding remark, we are having with us Sanjay Kelikarji from the ministry. So may I request him to just share his views, because he is associated right from his start with the implementation of STRY, what kind of objective they were having in their mind, and now we are able to, as I mentioned, implement more than 1500 programs, train more than 25,000 rural youth, and success stories are also there. As DG sir mentioned, that now we will make deliberate attempt to capture these success stories, document these success stories, because success stories are created, but for some reason we never try to document them. Now we will make deliberate attempt to document those success stories and share with everyone. Sanjay Kelikarji.
Good morning, everybody. Sorry for the joining with this webinar due to some other schedule. So I welcome all the Samitis, KVKs, and a good initiative by Dr. Chandrasekhar sir regarding this presentation of documentation of success stories for the skill training of rural youth. As you know, all Samiti and KVKs are well aware that every year we are running.
So sir, before we conclude, I'll request you for your concluding remark, DG sir.
We spent exactly 60 minutes watching Urmila Mandvi of Chhattisgarh, Ashwini Sahu, the mushroom grower, and our Sandeep Singh of nursery, and hearing about Akash Deep and Supinder Singh, organic farmers, I get a feeling that by conducting a very short-term program, like 7 days, STRY, we can motivate rural youth, can transform rural youth into entrepreneur, and we have watched actually what is the impact of this program. If you think that STRY is another government program, we can give the training, and we can give the utilization certificates to manage, and manage will give to ministry, and that is the end of the program. It is not so. It is producing results in the field. And as a team, we are 124 people here. As a team, ministry, manage, committees, and all the KVKs and NTIs who are involved in this training program feel proud when we see Urmila Mandvi, the poultry farm. This is the product out of this training program given by you all people. It is not a small achievement. Without training, Urmila would have continued as an agriculture labor. You have given new dimension to her life. I'm sure that watching this video and getting inspired and pursuing many more rural youth in our training programs, hundreds of Urmila Mandvi will take birth in different parts of the country. That is the purpose of this cross-learning through this success stories webinar series initiated by MANAGE. So here, especially, Ashwini Sahu success story, not only he learned, you saw actually his wife and the daughter. All three people are involved. It has become a family business. The family is one of the basic principle in extension is whole family approach. You want to teach something, you teach to the entire family. Anyway, we are not practicing that. But this is the impact when you teach the entire family. Whenever somebody is free, whoever is free, they supplement and complement the income generating activity of the family. That is what we could see here. Not only he became self-employed, Ashwini Sahu, he also became trainer. He conducted training for other people. In fact, we should involve him as a trainer in forthcoming training programs. The success story should be made part and parcel of our STRY training program. It will greatly motivate all the participants. When they go back, they may forget about your resource person. They will not forget about the success stories. So the success stories of your previous program, they will be resource person for your future programs. this is one of the great learning out of this, you know, webinar series. And I would like to compliment, you know, Dr. Deepthi Jha, then Dr. Mukherjee, Dr. H.K. Singh, and another program coordinator who coordinated about this poultry. I would like to compliment them. They have taken personal interest. Very passionately, they conducted program. And as a result of that, they could able to produce, you know, very good success story, which can inspire the rest of the country. So coming to Punjab, very good, you know, success stories. I would like to compliment Dr. Harneet Kaur and Mr. Aman for conducting very effective training program and creating success stories. But organic farming is concerned, for committee and NTIs, I have a word of, you know, advice. This 7 days is a very short time. We cannot conduct a very generic program covering so many subjects. As far as possible, we can stick on to one training topic, one enterprise, which, you know, we can deal very intensively. For example, when you talk about organic farming and aromatic medicinal plants, large number of issues were dealt. 7 days is a very short time. So we can focus on single enterprise. We can focus on that enterprise very intensively for 7 days, cover 360 degree aspects of that single enterprise. We can have a deep impact on the minds of entrepreneur. Then organic farming, this nursery part, very encouraging. Hardeep Singh, Sandeep Singh nursery is, you know, very encouraging success story. I would like to compliment Pamiti, KVK, and all the entrepreneurs for showcasing the success stories. I think every month, if you spend 60 minutes like this and seeing success stories from different parts of the country, I am sure we will find a lot of meaning in work what we are doing. We are not just implementing one program and giving a utilization certificate. It is the process of building society, enterprising society. It is the process of building a strong nation which can lead the globe in future. You are all contributing for that. Let us carry the pride of doing something good for the nation. Thank you very much. I am seeing Sanjay Kalikarji. There was some obstruction, but now you can intervene and you can also share your views.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Thank you. So, thank you very much, sir, for emphasizing some important point. First, of course, is sir mentioned about a small program creating big impact. Because many times when you speak about some skill-based program, time for you allotted is just 6 days, 7 days. In that, 30%, 40% is again some theory time. So that doubt can come in your mind that what kind of impact this program will create. But when you go through the success stories like this, you clearly can understand that what kind of impact actually these short duration programs can create. Sir also mentioned about important thing, because many time I have seen we speak about initiative like digital green and all that, and USP of those kind of initiative is that farmer actually are producing the videos. So when you somebody see from your own group doing something, that actually create a great impact on you. That encourages you to take something. In one of the success story, Deepthi Madam also mentioned about that he further created or trained 5 more rural youth. So definitely that is a great point, sir, mentioned that these success story, these rural youth can be used as resource person, because many time it's not about, it is also about creating that that faith that, yeah, this can be done. Your practical 6-7 days of interaction may actually provide those techniques, but creating that belief that actually it can be done will only come when these farmers will interact with these kind of success story, these kind of rural youth. One more thing, sir, mentioned about that, yeah, we keep on speaking about inclusiveness. Means when a farmer is a farmer family is involved, can we do something to involve each and everyone, particularly the women? So in these kind of interventions, in these kind of initiative, you will see that entire family is getting involved. And that actually is in long run we want to achieve in this rural areas, you can say. So thank you very much, sir. You highlighted some very important point, and I'm quite sure, means though I am associated with this program for last almost 3 years, but we keep on interacting with different STRY coordinators. We keep coming, they keep informing us that this is the kind of impact we have created. We have created success stories. But when you throw a platform like this, listen to those success stories, you actually start believing that these are the components that actually make a story successful. These are the things that each one of us is expected, and this is the kind of impact these small short duration programs can create. Thank you very much, sir, for having this kind of vision, for helping us to organize a webinar series. And I feel that today we have made a reasonable good beginning. And as I mentioned, that next month, in the month of March, on 16th, again, we are going to meet. And states are Tamil Nadu and Manipur. We again expect them to share one or two success stories. First of all, before we conclude this, I'll just want to express my thanks, my gratitude to DG sir, not only for his time, not only for his guidance, but the kind of vision, because as a DG, you have so many activities, but still he is always thinking about each and every component that we are implementing. It was completely his idea to have something like, to create a platform like this, where different states can interact. And I'm quite sure that we will be able to, at least we understand that if you are training 100, all rural youth cannot be converted into success stories. But rate of conversion of success stories will definitely go up when we will interact through platforms like this. I'm also thankful to ministry, because it is the continuous support and involvement of the ministry which keep us pushing. Because STRY sometimes, say for example, this year also, it was a difficult year. We were supposed to organize 200 programs, or 300 programs are already in the pipeline. And I'm quite sure by the end of March, we will be able to organize another 100 programs. So whatever funds are available, we will be able to utilize. And that is possible only when we are having continuous guidance, support, involvement from the ministry. So I just want to express my thanks to JS Madam, Sanjay Ji, Jain Sahab, Prashant Ji, the entire team that is there at the ministry. I just want to express on behalf of Manage, on behalf of STRY team, I just want to express my thanks. And of course, Samiti Chhattisgarh, especially Deepti Jha Madam, for making such a wonderful presentation, and also the team from Pameti Ludhiana, Harmeet Kaur Ma'am and Dr. Aman, for sharing two important success stories. I'm also thankful to all the directors. Because STRY is a small component, but whenever we organize some kind of meeting, the kind of, I was just saying, at one point of time, number was 130, 135. So the kind of response we get from all the samitis, the involvement we get. So I'm thankful to all the directors, STRY nodal officers, and of course, the coordinators of different NTIs for making this program a success. And I'm quite sure from next time onward, we will be able to organize we will be able to share our success stories more in a more organized manner. So thank you, everyone. Thank you, DG sir. Thank you, officers from the ministry. Thank you, officers from the samitis, NTIs. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you all.
Thank you, sir.